Right, welcome to another video by Sparky, and in this video we're going to review Superman the Animated Series, the complete series. Now, like the previous video that I have done with Beware the Batman, this complete series is only available to buy from the US, Region 1. I do believe some of the individual volumes of the series are available to purchase in the UK, whether that's all of them I'm not sure. But certainly I've seen some, but I picked this full setup, so we'll go ahead and still get it. I got this a few years ago, but you can still get the show on Amazon just now. So that's outside the box. So you can see it's this is actually push out, so it's a little bit 3D, and it's got that nice shine to the box as well. Inside is the same as the out. Some of the characters in the back there, we got Clark Kent, Superman, Clark Kent, Jimmy Olsen and Lois Lane. And on the bottom here we have, that's Metallo, Brainiac, a Livewire, I forget this fella's name, but at the moment. And this was their version of, where was it again, General Zod. That they had done. He wasn't called General Zod, he had another name, but it was General Zod. That was the idea. That was same kind of character. So we'll open it up. Inside we get a nice little leaflet there. A little bit of wear and tear because I've had mine for a while. And it gives you the complete listings on the inside of what's on each individual disc. There we go, and the Superman logo on the back. Box 6 itself. Now, the one thing that I didn't like about this set is the fact that it's double disc, double-sided discs for each of the shows. So each show has three discs, technically, but they've made the second disc for volumes 2 and 3 double sided, which is not good. I had to use some of these cardboard sleeves you get when you buy empty DVDs to record onto and put them over the top so the DVDs don't get scratched. So if you do buy them, it's maybe worth looking into either getting these or buying yourself a new box to put this set in, which will have enough space to put all the discs in without worrying them getting scratched. So we'll get a look at the inside there. So another picture of Superman himself in the back. Then we have season 1. And like I said, it's a double disc. This is double sided. So you have got to be really careful that it doesn't get scratched. I do think it's a bad idea. Put something in front of it like I've done to stop it from getting scratched. That's when I've got season 2 there. Same again, the double sided disc. Season 3. And then we have a bonus disc on the back. I don't know why this was just put onto a disc 7. It's a special feature. The feature itself isn't on for that long, and it's only the one thing that is on it. And it was just a look into some of the villains that were used in the show itself. So that's to say, if you've anybody who was around about 10 to 12, 13 years old back in the 90s, remember this show? Very nostalgic show for me. It was released around about the same time as the 90s Batman show. This came out a year or so after the success of the Batman show. The same team tackled doing a Superman show. And I believe in the US it was a Superman Batman hour every week, where they would show an episode of Superman and then an episode of Batman. And I do believe some one or two of the shows that were showing were two-parters, so you got the same story over the hour. They did a very good job with this show. One of the problems that they always say that you have with Superman is getting villains that can hurt Superman. So unlike some of the comics where he's a Man of Steel, he's more or less unhurtable, they do make him a little bit more soft, if you like. So you can, the guys he's fighting do actually pose a threat. Because if they don't pose a threat, after all, you're not interested. But there were some good villains added in, who eventually, I believe, made it into the comics, who weren't in the comics, and some who weren't big major characters, but got more of a role in the comic books after that. One of those characters being Lobo. Lobo was very good. He's like a galaxy biker from an alien world. He's got the white skin and the red eyes and the long black hair, and he was actually voiced by the same fella that did Everybody Loves Raymond, and he played Robert in that show, his brother. And his voice is very, very distinctive, and he did a very good job. And of course, you've got the famous ones like Tom Clancy doing the Lex Luthor. And Superman himself, I believe, was voiced by... My name slipped me. Who it was? Tom Daly, that's who it was. So definitely, I would definitely look into picking this up if you're a massive Superman fan. If you want the complete series like this, you'll have to have the region go to America to get it. Now, unlike the Beware the Batman ones, this one I checked in other DVD players that are UK based, and these do in fact actually play in UK players. So you won't have any problems with having to have a region 1 DVD this time round. These discs will play in all players. Most of, I have noticed, the DC stuff from this period, whether it be the Batman of the Future, or the original Batman series, which I've picked a couple of the seasons of that up as well from the US, do actually play in the UK players. I don't know if they're completely multi-region. I would imagine so. If they're playing in the UK players, I'd imagine they'll play in anybody else's player. But these are definitely will work in your UK player. So that's it for the review. Definitely think about picking this up. I picked this up for a pretty good deal. It worked out around, by the time posting packaging, about £20 odd. By the time I got posting packaging, don't know what price it is now. But definitely go on to Amazon.com. That's where you have to go, and you'll find this set on there. And Amazon.co.uk will show you available to purchase from America, but you generally find if you go into the Amazon.com, they will sell it slightly cheaper and the equivalent of pounds than they do in dollars. I've found that with a lot of the stuff, even if it's coming from the US on the UK site, for whatever reason, it seems to be a little dearer for the sets. But definitely go to Amazon.com and just order it from there. Your same password that you use, email and password you use for .co.uk will work in .com as well, so you won't have to make up a new profile or anything like that. Yeah, so thanks for watching the video. Give it a thumbs up if you liked it. Feel free to leave any comments so you can improve these videos and make them better for everyone. And feel free to subscribe as well and put the name out. And if we get enough on the way of videos, I'll start doing more. We'll start taking requests. And I might even start doing some reviews on some wrestling shows and things of that nature, if we can get enough subscribers for that. So, like I said, hit the thumbs up if you liked the video, and thanks very much, and see you again next time. Thank you.